I am Dr. B P Mruthyunjayanna, neurologist at Mallige and Malaya Hospital. I want to speak about the awareness of epilepsy and how people get epilepsy, what are the types of epilepsy, what are the management to be done when the patient gets epilepsy. This everybody should know about these things. In epilepsy, there are so many types which I cannot explain within 5 to 10 minutes. One is common epilepsy, what you are seeing in the roads and other things is what is called generalized epilepsy or generalized tonic-clonic convulsions. That means patients suddenly without any information, they may fall to the ground. They will get movements of the limbs. That is, we call it involuntary movements, abnormal movements of the limbs. And with turning of the head to the sides or passing urine at that time and bringing saliva out. These are the common things which all of you might have seen in the roads. This can happen to anybody at any time. There is no age limit. Usually what we see is between 10 and 40 years. It is more common, but still we can get in any age group. And cause or reasons for this also is too many causes are there, I'll tell you later on. But now, what to do when a patient gets a type of epilepsy in the road you are walking? What has to be done? That's most important. Here, when the patient is getting this abnormal movements of the limbs, you should not try to stop it. But if he is hurting or if some sharp objects is there, you have to remove it. And if possible, you have to remove the patient to a safe site, which may be difficult. But still, you can remove the objects which are hurting the patient. Then you have to turn the patient to a side if possible, and then see that whatever the saliva, what you call, that is secretions in the throat or in the mouth, usually all of us will be having. That usually, if you are not turning to the sides, these patients will swallow. While swallowing, part of it goes to the stomach and part of it goes to the lungs. If it goes to the stomach, it's okay, no problem. But if it goes to the lungs, then patient may get respiratory problem. Then you'll become breathless. And that's how most of the patients will die of epilepsy. Usually, most of the patients, or most commonly, nobody will die of the epileptic attacks. But the complications, like aspiration, what I said, that causes mortality. And you should see that patients should not be given anything by mouth at that time. Because lot of patients, what happens is, I've seen, they go, they bring a cup of water, oh, pour water to the mouth, they say, that is dangerous again. Because patient is not able to swallow anything at this stage, at least for a few minutes to half an hour. At that stage, you should not give anything. When the patient once becomes conscious, and is talking, or is aware of the surroundings, or is able to swallow the saliva, at that time, of course, you can give some liquids. That also sometimes, after the epileptic attack, they may vomit. Therefore, if possible, if he is swallowing, you can give. Because sometimes, these epileptic attacks, especially in diabetics, due to low blood sugar, that is hypoglycemia, they may get an attack. Therefore, most of the patients with diabetes, sometimes they will keep a card in the packet. Therefore, just see in the pocket, search for his address and what are the diseases he's having. Some of the intelligent people, they keep it in the pocket, especially hypertensive patients, diabetic patients. And if he's a known epileptic, that also it would have been written in identity card. Therefore, they have to identify and address will be there. You have to inform their people. And then in the meanwhile, make the patient to turn to the side, see that he breathes well. And if he is wearing tight dress and other things, you have to release it, and so that the neck, especially some people, they wear collar, neck collar, which is very tight. Those things has to be loosened. And then you have to plan to shift the patient to a nearby hospital, because there next they will take care of it, and they have to investigate whether the patient has got hypoglycemia, or the patient is a known epileptic, whether he has stopped the drugs, and all these things they will see there. Therefore, what are the drugs he was taking, it has to be continued. Now, what I said so far is, a generalized major epilepsy with loss of consciousness. And this episode, as I said, they will pass urine sometimes. They bite their tongue. That also is a more common thing. And you should see that they should not bite the tongue, but you should not keep anything by the mouth. Some people I have seen, they put their fingers. That is dangerous because they don't know they will bite the fingers also. Therefore, put some soft tissue in between the teeth and see that he doesn't bite the tongue. That's all. And after the patient becomes conscious, then make arrangement to shift the patient. This is the one type of epilepsy you see. There are so many other types of epilepsies also. For example, patient will be conscious, but he throws one limb, just movement, involuntary movements of the limb, and twitchings of the angle of the mouth. And this loss, for example, just throwing like this, and then angle of the mouth. But still he will be aware of the surroundings. He knows what is happening to him, but after this episode, he may develop weakness of the part of that limb which was shaking. And then if it is on the right side, he will not be able to speak for a few minutes to a few hours sometimes. This is called aphasia. And then the weakness may persist for a few minutes to a few hours. Therefore, this patient also has to be managed in the hospital. And again, the same thing, whether it is a known epileptic, whether a mixed drug, and these things has to be given. And there are other types of epilepsies also, wherein patient is just sitting and just he stares. Is over. This what I have shown is, a type of typical temporal lobe epilepsy wherein patient is going smacking of the lips like this and then staring look and then looking around and then searching movements, goes on looking for something and then he will be wandering in the room and this that type. And this is also a type of epilepsy. So many times people will not make of what is there. People will think that if a patient is unconscious and is fallen, if he is throwing the limbs, there is epilepsy. No, this is also a type of epilepsy. In some other cases, epilepsy is there, wherein, for example, a child. Child gets an absence attacks. How child is going to the school, and for a few seconds, child is not able to talk, not able to hold the pen, just sitting like this. I'll show you now how it happens. That's all, over. If the child is standing, the child will be standing. This lasts only for a few seconds, 5 to 10 seconds or maximum 15 seconds. This nobody can aware of it because child is able to stand and just a few seconds is not aware of anything and just sometimes blinking of the eyelids and sometimes smacking of the lips. And very rarely they pass urine in the clothes. This is what is called absence attacks. And there are other types of epilepsies also wherein it is called hot water epilepsy. This is especially in Karnataka. Lot of people, they take bath daily, and especially when they take bath to the head bath, especially with hot water, after a few mugs of water pouring over the head, they get altered consciousness. As I said, in the temple of epilepsy, just they may stare like this and then open, then smack. Then in the bathroom itself, they may become unconscious and then they get what is called generalized tonic-clonic convulsions, shaking of the limbs and head like this, and these things goes on. This also happens. This is a dangerous thing because they are taking bath. If there is some stove or electric, they may fall, they may injure themselves. Therefore, for such patients, they should be very careful. They should not lock the door and they should always, the door should be opened, and then there should not be gas or any other electric connections which may hurt their body. Therefore, this is a very important thing which you have to take care of. And there are so many other seizures. For example, what is called laughing epilepsy, we say. That is, just patient goes on laughing. What? Like this. This is also epilepsy. And this is Intermittently, if any abnormal movements, abnormal things, if your patient gets lasting for a few seconds to minutes, one has to think of a type of epilepsy or seizure phenomenon. And this happens due to irritability of the cerebral structures, that is neurons in the brain. Therefore, this may happen due to so many causes, as I said in the beginning. It may be due to a more common thing which people will think of is tumors. Tumor is not that common, but still tumor can cause this focal seizures, what is called, as I said in the beginning. If the tumor is present on the left side, right side they may get a sort of twitching of the limbs or shaking of the limbs. And in some of the cases, what happens is they get some sensory disturbance, that is sensation starting from the foot, which ascends up, involves the right of the body, goes to the right upper limb, then the face, then the head. They say, sir, something is coming up from my toe. It comes up, ascends up, involves the half the body, then I lose consciousness. Therefore, there again they may go generalized tonic-clonic conversion, they may get. To start with, they are aware of everything. And in some of the cases, as I said, focal seizures. It may start the great toe, and then it ascends up, and then involves the body, right off the body like this, and the face goes like this, and then patient gets a full-blown attack. These are the various types. Still, so many types are there in epilepsy. And in children especially, they may get what is called, it starts myoclonic jerks. Jerks means child is there, suddenly it's a jerk. And then what is dog? Drop attacks. Child is there, get jerks, suddenly falls like this. Head will be taken to the table. And this child goes on getting, this is most of the cases, at least about 2 to 3% of epilepsy in children, we do see this one. And other types of epilepsy is just myoclonic jerks. That means some of the people, they get myoclonic jerks. That means jerks of one part of the body like this, or entire body like this, or one half the body. This is called jerks. This myoclonic jerks, especially during sleep, most of the people they get, but it is not dangerous, it is not a disease if they get just before going to sleep. We treat this myoclonic jerks when the patient gets these episodes, when the patient is awake, when he is sitting, when he is taking a cup of coffee, or when he is brushing his teeth, suddenly they may get a jerk and he may drop things from the hand. This happens. This is the myoclonic jerks. It has to be treated and is more common in children and which persists for a number of years. Therefore, for all these epilepsies, one is first it has to be diagnosed what is the type of epilepsy and other things, and then we have to investigate to know the cause, whether the patient has got any other diseases like hypertension, diabetes, and any cerebral tumors, and any tuberculosis of the lungs and things like that, because sometimes tuberculomas, tuberculosis of the brain, tuberculosis meningitis, infections of the brain, that is other types of meningitis, and abscess in the brain, and as I said in the beginning, tumors of the brain, all these things can cause epilepsies. But what I've seen is in 60 to 70% of the cases, there will be no reason for the type of epilepsy. It is called idiopathic. In about 30 to 40%, we may get some information by doing these tests like EEG, CT scan, MRA brain, and other blood investigations. For example, as I told you in the beginning, hypoglycemia can cause, hypocalcemia can cause these seizures, and then some thyroid diseases can cause these epilepsies. And then other metabolic disorders can cause epilepsies. There are so many causes. Therefore, by investigating, we can come out. But treatment has to be started. And there are two schools of thought. One school, immediately after one attack of seizures, they start treatment. There is another school where they think to call a person is an epileptic, he should have at least two attacks. That is the nature. But here the problem comes, because what we have seen is a person may get an epileptic attacks. There are so many patients who gets attacks once in 3 years, 5 years, 7 years like this. But there are patients who normally we see, they get average about 6 to 10 attacks in a year. Therefore, whether to treat these patients who get once in a year, once in 3 years or not is very difficult to say. But suppose if a person is working in a place wherein is handling with machineries or machines or which is very dangerous for his body and other things, there treatment has to be started. And other epileptics, of course, after one or two attacks, the treatment has to be given. And once you start the treatment, treatment has to be continued anywhere from 3 to 5 years. Not a question of 3 months, 6 months like that. Therefore, for example, head injury patients, they get seizures. There what we do is, after the head injury, to prevent seizures, we give anti-epileptic drugs. In some of the cases, the surgeons, they give for 6 months to 1 year, because we know the cause, it is injury to the brain, and then after the treatment, they might have recovered completely, therefore they give. In most of the other cases, we give for a long time. Therefore, for example, lot of people, what you have seen is, one of the most commonest cause is cysticercosis. That is a worm infection which is present in the stomach, this worm, cysticercosis, which travels in the blood and lodges in the brain. And then in the brain it causes a cyst. That irritable cyst can cause epilepsy. This is most common, especially we thought it is more common in those who eat pig. But now we have seen, it need not be a non-vegetarian patient, a person who takes non-vegetarian food. It may be a person who takes a food, good vegetarian food also. Because here, especially vegetables, which is not washed cleanly. And because nowadays we know vegetables are grown with water which is coming from this bathrooms and other things. And this contains this eggs of the cysts and other things. Therefore, by eating these salads and other things, it may go and lodge in the stomach and later on in the brain, which causes cysticercosis of the brain. This can cause. Therefore, these are all the commonest causes. And investigations, as I said, important investigations are, at least if the patient gets a single attack, whether to investigate fully or not, it is decided by the doctor. Otherwise, a patient comes with seizures, and if he has got seizures for a longer time, and if he gets any symptoms of raised intracranial tension, what we mean is, if the person gets a tumor or some cyst in the brain or some other infection in the brain, usually they get headache. Headache worsens gradually, and this is a symptom of raised intracranial tension, we call it. Therefore, in such cases, a CT scan or MRI is a must. And in other cases, of course, it depends upon the treating physician or neurologist how to manage. And drugs wise, as I said in the beginning itself, this has to be given when once you start for a longer time. And patient, they have to consult their physician or neurologist, whoever it may be, depending upon the need, because sometimes drugs can cause reaction. Therefore, what we say is, they should consult the physician after starting the drug. And some of the drugs, when they are taking, it can cause some liver damage, or blood hemoglobin may come down, and calcium may come down, and they may develop osteoporosis in some of the cases. And these drugs, to assess this drug effect on the body, at least once in 3 to 6 months, these epileptic patients have to see their doctors. And if necessary, they have to be investigated. Therefore, treatment, as I said, it has to be continued at least for 3 to 5 years. And then, depending upon their EEG findings and other things, the doctor will decide whether the drug has to be stopped or not.